This is the audio journal of Dr. Vasily Korkin. He visited me again late last night. Subject Alpha from the teleportation experiment. That's the fourth time in the last 2 weeks. He materialized out of nowhere. He seems to be more corporeal with every appearance. I must admit, he frightens me. A little. There is such malice in his eyes.
By now, you should see the courtyard you'll need to pass through.
Все чисто.
Challenging. I also know your tasks are nearly impossible. But you are accomplishing what no other scientist on Earth have done. You are harnessing the power of E99. Continue your work, and know that you are helping Mother Russia in ways you could not possibly imagine.
Область чиста!
Captain Ranko! Over here! We made it inside the fence!
Yes, yes! One moment.
The fence is on! Ready for the elevator!
It's on the way!
Dr. Beresov, the power is out! Reiko, we have to hold them off until Beresov gets the power restored!
The generators are gearing up. Renko, use the TMD to renew the power junctions on the fence. That should buy us some time. just fixed it. The elevator should almost be there.
Finally! Come on, Renko! Let's get to the tower! This way, Renko! That's a nice bit of work down there, Renko.
My God, you haven't aged a day. Remarkable. You've undoubtedly figured out the timeline has been altered. Russia rules the world, and Demichev is the Chancellor. Here, let me show you what happened to the world after you saved Demichev from the burning building. From the moment I invented the TMD, Demichev wanted it. He demanded I hand it over for him to use in his research. When I refused, he had me and everyone else who wouldn't cooperate labeled as traitors. If it weren't for you, I would have been killed along with everyone else. Demichev was obsessed with the power and possibilities of the Singularity. But a few months after it came online, there was a terrible accident. The Singularity exploded, killing thousands instantly. But they were the lucky ones. Those who survived were left to a fate worse than death. The E-99 radiation mutated every living thing on the island, including humans. The island was quarantined and abandoned, but not before E-99 had been effectively mass-produced and implemented in everything from microwaves and vehicles to weapons more powerful than America's atomic bomb. On the heels of this success, Demichev was able to quickly rise through the party ranks, preaching all the while that Russia had a technological advantage it must use quickly and ruthlessly. And Premier Khrushchev agreed. Russia launched a preemptive strike against the United States, devastating its entire East Coast with a single E-99 bomb. Simultaneous attacks were also launched across Europe. Germany, France, Great Britain. None could stand against the E-99 weapons of the USSR's troops. Within 6 months, the entire world was under Khrushchev's control. But not for long. Demichev used his growing number of supporters to oust Khrushchev and install himself as Chancellor for life. So you see, the timeline has been altered, but it can be corrected, and the Singularity is the key. With it, Demichev rose to power, and the Soviet Union dominated the world.
If you destroy the Singularity in the past, history will correct itself.
But the only thing that can destroy the Singularity is something of equal power. The E-99 bomb Khrushchev desired. There's one aboard a freighter that sunk in the harbor when the Singularity exploded. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Take that elevator down into the old rail line. From there, you'll have to travel to the docks. Catherine and I will do our best to help you.